April 17th, and it is around 7:30. It's on a Friday. I really haven't got on here, and I really have not done a reflection in a few days, in about a week, I think. So I'll just basically explain what's been going on for a few days. So, like, the last time you guys saw me, it was the day before my birthday. I was going to turn 22. I'm 22 now. So basically, I'm going to reflect on a birthday in quarantine and what I did. Didn't do much. And then I'm just going to talk about some of the things that have changed in the last few days and how I'm seeing it and how my family's dealing with it. So, like I said, my birthday was on April 8th. I turned 22. Me and my twin sister. And I've never been the person to get big about my birthday, but when you can't do something, it sucks. When you're stuck inside, it sucks. And it's like, oh, you had all these big plans. My big plans are probably going out to dinner with a couple friends, but when you really can't do anything, it's not fun. It really does. It's like, dang. Like when you, like the last few years, I've never done anything for my birthday. Now, when I can't, I want to do it. It's a blessing to see another year. I stayed home with my family, my mom and my little sister, and they made us cupcakes, and we all sit here and we ate cupcakes, and we probably watched a movie or something. I did homework all day. I didn't even think I had an exam that day, but in something that's like, there's a lot of birthdays in my family. It's like my grandma's was the 31st, ours was the 8th, and my little sister, she turns 9 on May 3rd, and so we're probably going to do, I don't know, something. She wanted a pancake birthday party, so we'll make it work. We'll see what can happen. But basically, what I'm going to reflect on is, like, today's April 17th. I live in the state of Iowa, like I said, and Governor Reynolds just announced that none of the community schools or public schools, or like the elementary, high school, middle school, intermediate schools, they're not going back. They're not in session anymore. And with me going to school to be a teacher, that really, like, opened my eyes. It's like, wow. Because when most people think, oh, it would be awesome, it would be great to be a teacher right now, it would not. These teachers are away from 24 plus of their favorite people that they're with, that they are with on a daily basis, that they're with from 8 to 4:30 sometimes, 8 to 3:25, whatever time they get out of school. They're with them 5 days a week. And for it just to be taken away that fast from something that teachers put so much passion and so much love into their job, and they spend so much time on it, and for it just to be literally taken away until it's like they grow connection with their students. Like, their students are in, and most teachers are like, oh, my kids. It's because they grow such a connection with their students, and my heart goes out to the teachers, because it's something that I will never want to experience in my life, ever, ever, ever. Yes, teachers love their summer breaks, but they're excited to go see their students once it comes around in August. And so a lot of my friends who are teachers right now, my heart goes out to them. One lady, I work with her at a summer camp, and like it says, she loves kids. Like, she is a teacher all year long, and then comes and works at a summer camp with 100 plus kids, and that just shows you the passion she has for children. And just as like, and usually teachers aren't calm people. They're not, well, I can sit at home for a little bit. Teachers are people that are on the go, go, go. And so it's completely different. Like, my little sister, she is in third grade, and her teacher, they're doing Zoom, and it's just something that, and her teacher is just like, it's completely different, and everyone's lives are changing so fast. But that's the biggest thing that has happened in the last few days. And just, like, when it happened today, it's like, oh, schools are closed. Like, everyone knew, like, everyone were leaning towards that, but went to hear it. And my heart goes out to the seniors. And we have people that are like, oh, it doesn't matter, it's senior year, it didn't matter. But they don't get to graduate. There's kids that are first-generation students, that are first-time graduates of their family, that they can't go to prom. Their sports are taken away. Kids that were going to, this season was going to determine if they get a scholarship to college, if the scouts are going to come watch them. And there's so much more than just saying, oh, you don't get to graduate. There's so much more. There's kids, like, the sports, there's vocal, there's music things, like, large music festival or large group music festival, and kids were going to, and just different things, that competitions, and, like, kids, people that dance and just different things that have, like, it's so crazy because there's so much, like, that's going on, and everyone's like, oh, it's okay, their senior year, it's all good, you can graduate from college. But you go to school from kindergarten to 12th grade, and then for them just to get their, like, it's taken away. It's literally taken away, and oh, my heart goes out to them, because that's something people, they don't get to do the prom, and like I said a few seconds ago, the kids, like, there was kids that would, like, this coming sports season, their spring sports season, that if they play soccer, if they play softball, baseball, track, if they do a sport, if they're in music, if they're in band, and if they were going to go perform somewhere, and if, it's just, there's so much that these kids lost, and my heart goes out to the senior class. It really does. It really, really does. But something else I'm going to reflect on a little bit is that's kind of, like, nerve-wracking to me is that you're seeing this. I know you're not supposed to believe everything you see on the internet, but there's schools around the country already talking about not having online classes next semester. And with, it's just, like, so scary. Like, with me being an education major, I start my big classes next year where I get into the class, where I get to learn how to actually teach and become a teacher. And that's going to be hard to learn online. Like, we have students right now, we have kids in their block, they call them blocks. We have kids in their block classes right now that are learning how to teach online. And it's just, you go from hands-on learning to face-to-face learning. And it's just such a, so much. Like I said a couple videos ago, so many questions, so many what ifs. What if this happens? What if this happens? What are we going to do? And no one really has the answer right now. Like, that's the thing. No one has the answer right now. And that's what's just, I think, nerve-wracking to everyone else. And so, I say this every video. It's crazy. So much has been going on. No one really knows when it's going to stop, how it's going to stop. And so, something that, like, else that I'm really, really, really nervous about is I'm a camp counselor. I've done it this would be going on my 9th year. And when I listen, most people say, oh, the most wonderful time of the year is December. No, the most wonderful time of the year is between June 1st and August whatever, when I get to spend time with my camp kids and I'm in session with my camp kids. And I'm like, am I going to have camp this summer? Am I going to be able to spend my summer with 100 plus kids? And so that's something that I've been reflecting on. I'm like, I may not have a summer job. And there's just so many different questions that everyone has to ask. And no one, like I said, no one really has the answer. But social distancing, we'll cover that. That's really, it's crazy because as me, like, I'm a people person. I love being outside. And so it really hasn't, like, took a toll on me yet. Like I said, you have your days, you have your moments, you have your times where you just want to stay in your room. But then you have your times when you want to go outside. But luckily, the weather hasn't been the best. Like, today, I woke up with literally a little over an inch of snow outside. It is completely gone. And so something that I did to keep myself busy is I brought a pair of skates. Sadly, they ripped, so I got to send them back, and I'm just going to order a new pair. But it's like, just keep yourself busy. And I see, like, next week the weather's going to be nice outside. I'm going to be outside in my hammock. I'm going to be doing my homework outside. And so that's one thing I've really, like, came to conclusions with, is make sure to keep yourself busy. Don't just sit in your room and, like, eat when you're not hungry. Eat when you're bored. Don't do that. Just have a set schedule. I say this all the time. Have a set schedule. Have a to-do list. Like, and something else there, like, I redid my room. Like, when I came here, I had nothing around my room. I was sitting between four white walls. And, like, that's not me. So I had my tapestry up. I added lights around my room. And so just to make me feel a little bit more, like, happy. I'm like, oh, I wake up. Oh, there's the lights. But so we're going on, we're at the end of, I think, week 4 of, like, really social distancing. And so it's crazy. It is insane. 30 something days, and it's like, when are we gonna really go back to our new normal, are we in our new, like, are we ever gonna go back to the way it used to be? How long is it gonna take? And it's like, it's crazy. There's so much is gonna change. So much is gonna have to change. And that's another thing that I keep asking. What's gonna happen to these kids that are still in elementary school, high school, middle school, that are not, like, some school districts, like the school, like, here in Iowa, school districts have the choice to either force their, like, it was, like, required to do online school, or it was an option for the kids to do it. And, like, our school district chose, like, the option. And so, like, my mom, she wakes up every day, does stuff with my sister every day, just, like she does her reading, her writing, her math. She does that every day. She goes through the things that the teachers have sent her. But the kids that struggle in school, like, for me, I was a kid that struggled in school. If this would have happened to me when I was still in elementary school, it would have been scary. I would have felt so far behind. And that's what, like, with me going to school to be a teacher and a special ed teacher at that, that's really what, like, scares me and really, like, what's going to happen to these kids that are still in elementary school that are not getting the help that they need, that are not, there's just so many questions, like I say, the what if question, what are we going to, like, what's going to be done? And so, like, when they go back to school next fall, but so much has happened, so much will continue to happen, so many things will continue to change, and it's a sad thing. It breaks my heart every day. And it's sad, like, every day around 11 o'clock, my phone, Channel 13 News comes on my phone, the new cases, and sadly, the death toll here in Iowa, and it breaks my heart every day, and I'm like, wow. And actually, I'll touch a little on this, part of our state, I think it's called Region 6, it's, like, in the Waterloo area, if you know where that's at, they were kind of put on a shelter-in-place thing, and I'm like, wow. So, that's basically what's been going on, and so much has happened. I've been rambling, but all I gotta say is make sure you keep yourself up and if you're watching this and you're in school, don't stress yourself out, because it can get a lot. Like, I found myself this week, I'm like, I have this to do, I have that to do, I don't know when I'm gonna get it done, and it's like, you have nothing to do but school. You have so much to do because it's online. You have these assignments, and one assignment can take a whole day, and you're like, I didn't get anything else done. But it's going to get better. I know. I pray, and so much has changed. I just keep saying that, but it will get better. But so, yes, thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys later. Bye-bye.